right. So, where our children's sermon kind of started, we're going to kind of pick up right there. The wonder of the Jesus story, the Christmas story, the stunning reality that we live in, as John's gospel puts it, that God put on flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood, that Jesus is our God who is with us, our Emmanuel. So for many of us, you know, this is something that we may have heard for most of or all of our lives. And so like the sheer just ridiculousness and profound beauty of the incarnation in many ways has become kind of old hat. You know, it's just like, yeah, it's just like, yeah, that's what Jesus did. That's what God does, right? You know, like it becomes very normal for us. Which isn't a bad thing, but I think one of the things that we can do as a community of people who are with and for each other is we can be people who continue to point toward the wonder and the mystery of the Christmas story and who keep asking, okay, what are we going to do about this? And so our time together today is aimed at doing that by intentionally embracing the reality that today pivots on this new year. We welcome a new year today. And again, well done for being here to be a part of this today as we begin this new year. But what this is going to look like, we're going to walk through a few exercises together, a few questions, a process that I learned from a podcast that I listened to. It's called Lead Stories. It's with two female pastors who are just awesome. Steph Williams and Joe Saxton are their names. And they call this exercise Goodbye and Hello, a way of moving from the year that has ended into the new one that is before us. And at Sawhouse, you know, we try to create space to do practices like this, to just moments where we stop and look at our lives and really listen to God with great intention. Does that sound good? All right. So hopefully you got a bulletin and a pen. If not, David's here to hand one out because you're going to need some paper and a pen to do this. So just kind of, he's going to be wandering around. So just say, oh yeah, I need that. There's some pieces of paper that you'll need inside as well as something to write with. I make no promises that those pens in that basket actually work, but you can at least try. So yes, so get that ready. And there's two pieces of paper inside of the bulletin. First, we're going to use the one that has all the kind of announcement-y things on it. And on the back side, you'll see a scripture verse and then a lot of blank space for notes. We're going to start with that one, if that makes sense. So we'll start with the one that has a mostly blank backside with a scripture verse. And for folks who are watching online, Happy New Year to folks who are tuning in. Also, I just feel like this is really something that a process that someone can do. If you're home in your jammies, you can also do this right now. So pull out that pen and paper to be a part of this as well. So kind of getting those tools ready, I want us to begin by hearing again Psalm 139, verses 1 through 6. This time we're going to hear it in the Message paraphrase. So we got to hear kind of a kid's version of it, which I really loved. But now we're going to hear it in a more modern version, an adult version, I guess. And it's different. I'm actually going to read a different version that's in your bulletin, but you can take that one with you. It's going to be on the screen, but I would invite you, if you can hear well, if you need to see it in order to really hear it, go ahead and read along. But otherwise, I invite you to close your eyes and listen. Just listen and hear this intimate description of the closeness of our Emmanuel. Oh, and hear this as a word of prayer for us. So this is Psalm 139, verses 1 through 6. God, investigate my life. Get all the facts firsthand. I am an open book to you. Even from a distance, you know what I'm thinking. You know when I leave and when I get back. I'm never out of your sight. You know everything I'm going to say before I start the first sentence. I look behind me and you're there, then up ahead and you're there too. Your reassuring presence coming and going. This is too much, too wonderful. I can't take it all in. And so with these kind of sacred words echoing in us, we begin with a look back at 2016. So we do a review of our lives. So take out that bulletin, insert, and use that empty space. We're going to use it for some brainstorming. So we're going to invite God to kind of guide us, our reflections, as we think back over this last year. And here are just a few areas to consider. We're just going to have a list that comes up as we go through this review. First, just what are some moments of joy and what were some moments of sorrow? What were those high points and what were those low points? What disappointed or frustrated us this year? What surpassed our hopes and our dreams? What was really great about this year too? What lessons have we learned about ourselves, about our friends, about our family, about the world? How has God been present in this year? So we're going to leave this on the screen for a minute, and in a second we're going to kind of give a few minutes of silence just to kind of be in these questions. But it's just, it was always good to write things down, I think, too. So use that space as you have it. Feel free to make it messy. This isn't like the final draft, so just like dive into it. I find it helpful to chronologically in my mind go through the year and kind of think about things, think about different relationships, circles I run in. And then we're going to pause now for a few minutes, just create space just to brainstorm, to write down our responses that describe 2016. So let me pray for us as we make that space. God, one of the ways that we grow in our faith, that we grow in hope, that we grow in trust, is to be people who look back, who remember, who notice, people who tell the stories of what you have done in our lives. And so we do that now. May we dare to be honest, even raw and vulnerable with you about this year. So give us eyes to see where you have shimmered in our stories, where you have been present, connecting us with others, holding us in love, and give us words to capture that, to name what our lives have been in 2016. So we listen for you now. The writing can continue, and both in the next few minutes, but also as you leave today. But having begun to make this list, written down some observations, now we're going to just have a chance to hold all of this past year and prayerfully ask God to reveal what to say goodbye to from the last year. So we prayerfully ask God, you know, God, what do we say goodbye to from 2016? So it's not simply that we're going to make New Year's resolutions, right? Those can be really helpful. Well on ya if you have some resolutions heading into this year. The point is to listen to what God might be asking us to let go of from this last year. It may be concrete ideas. It may be something like, I'm not going to be part of that group anymore. Or, you know, I think I'm going to stop doing this. They might be kind of concrete in that sense. However, more likely expect God to speak about matters of our heart as well. For example, like saying goodbye to shame. When we listen for God like this, just a word about this, God will often bring up pictures or images for us, sometimes memories or specific people, or there may be a specific Bible verse that comes to mind that kind of sticks with what we're thinking about. So listen with an ear knowing that God can really show up in creative ways in how and when we open ourselves up to that. So we're going to take, again, just a minute to ask God to reveal what we can say goodbye to as we head into this next year. So having begun to ask that question of asking God to reveal what to say goodbye to, again, this work can continue. We're going to kind of move through these steps, this process, which can continue as you leave too. But taking a look at that goodbye list, you know, what do you see there? Moving into next, we're going to pray, just taking a moment to release those things in our list. And remember, we can add to it later. But I invite you, just as you're ready, to either close your eyes or to keep your eyes on that list and to kind of put your hands on your lap, palms up, just a sign of that prayer of release that we're going to pray, if that's comfortable for you. But let's do that, just with great intention, those things that we sense God kind of saying, you know, let's let go of that. Let's, with intention, pray about those things. So let's pray. God, it is the dawn of a new year. And before we step fully into it, we intentionally take a moment and we open ourselves to you, holding open all that has happened in 2016, the good and the not so good, the beautiful moments and the ones that we wish we could change. And we release it all to you, Jesus, our Emmanuel, who has been with us through all of the year. We let it go, loosening our grip on the past, letting go, and letting neither the good nor the bad have definitive say over who we are and who we are becoming. So we loosen our grip on our past, knowing that you are our God who is always writing a new story. So we release it all to you, knowing that you unfold all of who we are, all of what this year has been, in your incredible, everlasting grace and abundance and peace. And for that, we say thank you, God. Thank you. Amen. So moving then to the next piece, as it is the dawn of a new year, with practicing this process of letting go our goodbyes, we then have room in ourselves for grabbing hold, for saying hello. So now we're going to ask God just to reveal to us what to say to hello to, what to receive as this new year begins. Hello. So here's the trick, though. Again, it is more than a list of what we're just adding to our life. I'm totally like a structure person, like, okay, what can I just start doing? And then I'll, you know, let me just stick it in there in the schedule. Not that it'll actually fit, but that's what I try to do. So it's not just that. Again, it's helpful to have those things, but the point of this particular way of being present with God, these hellos, is to listen to what God might be asking us to embrace as we enter this year, a posture, a way of being. And maybe, again, there might be some concrete ideas for what that looks like, which is awesome. However, do expect God, again, to speak about matters of the heart. For example, saying hello to accepting God's love and forgiveness deep in our bones, or saying hello to deeper hope or self-love or generosity of spirit. So in answering this, I'd also invite us to turn a particular ear toward how God is inviting us to embrace our capacity for creativity. This is something that we really dove into on Christmas Eve. If you haven't seen or heard the sermon, it's online. We'd love for you to hear it, because we'll keep referencing it in the next weeks to come. But we named on Christmas Eve that we, as we found ourselves at the manger again, that the great good news for all people was this invitation into the creativity that we are made for. Jesus arrived as a baby who would grow up to show us over and over again that the work of the Messiah, the presence of God in this world, is a creative, surprising, turning everything upside down way of being present. It's particularly turning the things upside down that are not the way that they should be. And so Jesus hands that work off to us, so we bring who we are, the creativity that we have, using innovation and imagination, to the places in our lives where it's needed, those broken relationships, those places where social justice is needed. So please have an ear, again, have an ear towards, like, you know, where could your hellos be turned in such a way that you can bring creativity into a relationship or a place of darkness in your life? So again, we'll make some space. Just write down what you hear. What do you want to say hello to? What's God saying? These may correlate in some ways to what you're saying goodbye to, but maybe not. And again, God can show up in creative ways in how we hear this. So just listen with an ear for that. So let's take a minute again just to say, okay, God, what do we say hello to in 2017? Let's pray. God, thank you that you are always doing a new thing, and that we get to be people who say hello to new possibilities in us and in the world, that we continue to be a work in progress, which is such a good word of mercy and grace and hope. And that's what we carry in us into 2017. And for what we have seen in 2016, oh Lord, we are in need of grace and hope, so thank you for that. Thank you for the hellos that you are helping us to say yes to. Continue to speak to us in these moments before us and in this year to come. So, friends, in almost the final movement of this is just looking at our response, how to respond. I want to name a few ways in which to respond to what we're kind of coming up with here. And first, I wonder just if there are things that you feel led to say goodbye to, that you're open to sharing with us here. If there are things that you are saying hello to, that you are willing to kind of share here. I just wonder if anyone wanted to just take a quick word from your seat, just kind of say, yeah, this is this is what's coming up for me. I know some of this stuff can be kind of vulnerable stuff, so don't feel like you have to, but if there's something, yeah, I can say that. It's always encouraging, and often God uses what we hear to kind of trigger, oh yeah, I want to do that too. Or, you know, like it puts us in a great place to hear what other people are thinking. So if you would like to share, feel free.
Hello to better self-care.
Amen and amen. Love it. Yep. Goodbye to heartbreak from being away from family and friends. Yes. Yes. For my hellos, I had some alliteration. It was people, prayer, and play. Just risking more of my time to be present with people and not the to-do list all the time. Prayer, just being more intentional about what that looks like, just soaking my life in prayer, and play, not taking everything so serious all the time. So those are some of my hellos. Anyone else? Cool, thank you. Cool. So second, just as we think about responding, here are just two questions that can help us move forward into a response. First, if not with us, like who will you share this list with? Like who can you speak to, a spouse, friend, mentor, parent? So holding that question. And then second, what is the next practical step in moving forward? It's like, okay, I want to spend more time with people. Okay, how can I talk to Jason about how can we have a cycle of just having, like, every Thursday we have dinner with other people? Or, you know, like, what does that look like? So what could be a next step as you look at these goodbyes, as you look at these hellos? Maybe pick one of those things and say, here's a practical thing that I could start moving towards, and to be specific about that. So maybe circle one and, like, I want to make a practical step about that one. And then finally, this is the last thing. It's been a lot of steps. So you still with me again? Okay. So the last one is simply to record, to write it down. So holding those questions of how we respond, keep holding that. We write it down, responding to it all. You have another sheet of paper that we tucked in there in your bulletin with two columns with those goodbyes and hellos. This is the less draft form for you to take. If you ended up using this as your place, that's okay too. But if you still have it blank, it's a great place to kind of give that kind of, okay, here's the more like formed response to these. And then to take this home with you and to put it in a place where you'll see it in the weeks to come or even in the whole year to come, just to let it be something that you can come back to. Let it be a practice that really shapes the year as we move into it, being intentional about what you are saying hello to. In this year. You know, it's interesting because New Year's Eve, New Year's Day, it's an arbitrary human design event, right? Like, and here shall be the day that we transition. You know, it's in many ways, it's like, okay, we just kind of picked that day. That's on the one hand, you know, we don't need a date on the calendar to tell us to listen for God and to be met with God's grace and being led into who God is calling us to be. And yet, a date on the calendar can also just be a moment that we can grab hold of to let God move us into an opportunity for growth and to engage with God's creativity. So that, my friends, is why we do this as yet another way to engage with a life of wonder. Wonder at the movement of God and how God can heal our past and birth a new future. Wonder at hope even when times seem darkest. And wonder at recognizing our God who truly is with us always. So friends, let's close this time with a final word of prayer. God, it is a new day. It is a new year, a fresh moment to see how you are at work in us and the world. And so with hope, with intention, we lay before you all that you've spoken to us and will continue to, our goodbyes, our hellos, and we ask for your spirit to be at work in us to make these goodbyes and hellos possible. Not as something that we check off our list as accomplishing, but something where we move into your grace and experience organically the ways in which you will shape us in the year to come. And in these next moments, as we sing again, as we listen some more and write down as we pray, God, we ask that you would form us through 2017 and beyond to be more and more in your image of love, of generosity, of justice, of grace. We look so forward to the ride together with you and with one another. So come, Lord Jesus, today and in this year to come.